Okay, I'm just going to get started here because it's been quite a day for me. Hello, everyone. You're watching this on the May 26th, maybe even May 27th, depending where you are in the world. If you're watching it, I'm taping it the May 25th here in the Bay Area of California. So it's already the 26th in places in the world. You may be watching on the 27th. We have now entered into the event horizon. The lights of the theater have dimmed. The crowd is hushed. The entrance music begins, and you realize the play is about to start. And so, you get this sort of jitters, like, "Wow, we're just about to have ourselves reflected to us somehow." I mean, this is really something. I've had a tremendously difficult day. I'm still standing by the grace of God. What I believe happened is that, remember that video a couple of videos ago, the how right spiritual practice snaps the bands of arrogance? Had this tremendous psychic shock deep within. And it didn't affect me at the time, but I believe this is a couple of days later, this is the effect of it. And it's really, wow. Okay, I've been clumsy today. I've been just kind of really sluggish and super tired, and just nothing I do works. Eat, stretch, do all the stuff, and nothing gets me. It's like nerves are like shock. I'm going sort of a shock sort of situation. And so this happens. It's a delayed reaction. And various insights are arising that I have to just wow them. Just okay, wow. I don't want to struggle with them. So all of the practices that we've done here, I'm having to employ them right now effectively, because we are now in this what's called the event horizon. And very simply, let's break this down for everyone. It's quite simple, actually. We're either going to go in a super negative direction or a super positive direction. That's it. This is what it's all about right now. So just process this. Just process this. We're either going to go in a super negative direction or a super positive. This is what it's all about. This is why we have prepared so strongly to go in a super positive way, because if we don't go in a super positive way, we're going to go in a super negative way. And we will end up finding the means to pull us into that, actually. However spiritual they may seem to be starting out, ultimately they lead us into super negative. So we've had to do a great deal of work to get comfortable and familiar with the super positive here. I have very strong indications today that the Dharma Kings are absolutely poison ready. Longchenpa, I prayed to Longchenpa. Immediately, he showed me something which showed him in a red hat with a toolbox running towards this, like a service, like a mechanic service. He says, "I am here with the full toolbox, okay, of skillful means, and I'm absolutely full out running, and we're gonna hit the ground running," and he is absolutely ready to go. Which is tremendous, tremendous. He's like a blue collar worker, the spiritual mechanic who has all the skills and all the whole skill set, knows how to bring us to a clear light vision of intrinsic spaciousness. And it's this practice, the clear light vision of intrinsic spaciousness, that snapped the band of arrogance, which is really was just the spiritual face of arrogance, which is a camouflage to drag us down into super negativity, which is means more arrogance, more arrogance. And that band was finally snapped. And this is, I think, the aftershock. I'm feeling it now. Had a number of dreams where I finally escaped the arrogance, and it really was quite shocking. Now last night I had a dream where I was there's this bin with rocks in it, and it was divided in the middle, and I had been looking through this on the left. I've been looking through these rocks and trying to find the prettiest ones for everyone. And then I decided, let me look over this other right side of this bin. And I started to look there, and oh my gosh, it was all like golden diamonds. Imagine the combination of gold and diamonds. All these stones were just exquisitely, sublimely beautiful. And there are some slabs there that when you move the slabs, music came, beautiful sounds came. And I was just saying, wow. But then I thought, well, I'm not deserving to distribute this stuff. And then I thought, well, maybe I am. I was thinking, like, why am I looking through this bin with all this coal, trying to find the prettiest pieces of coal where I can give out these gold and diamonds? And someone was there, and they said, yeah, they said, sure you can. Why don't you give this out? I'm thinking, wow. Yeah, why not? Why not? So there is just tremendous intensity right now. I've been saying May 27th around that time. And again, as you're watching this, it may already have been some May 27th somewhere in the world. So we have reached it. By and large, you can say we have now reached the time when this play of the super negative and super positive will begin. It will begin. Just let this sink in. Just wow this. Just wow it. So, my nerves are just like right now. They're just, I mean, my voice, I had nothing today. I could hardly drive. I was making all sorts of driving mistakes and just unawareness. It was scary. I just was out of it. And my voice, I couldn't sing. I tried to sing. Good Lord, there was no energy, no spirit, no zip. I'm just, have no zip today at all. It's just, whoa, just. Like a wet noodle, I can hardly function. It's amazing. I said, "Well, I feel in great shape, and yet I can hardly move my body around at all. This is shock, shock." So you have to take it as positive shock. It's the shock from some tremendously positive event. And this is part of the price that we pay for super positivity. We're not used to it, so it's kind of shocking when we get free. We're like, "Wow." So shocking, huh? We thought we were going to be enslaved forever, and all our defenses are designed to try and convince us that this is so. And by convincing ourselves this is so, somehow we believe we're going to be happy. Like if we convince ourselves we're going to be miserable forever, somehow that's going to equate to happiness. No, it just equates to misery, actually. But the good news is we're not going to be miserable forever. I came across something today, this huge. Wrought iron pot holder, urn holder, something that holds a huge urn, a big, vast, large, elevated pot of flowers. Super positivity. I got it. I said, wow. Really heavy. It was roof. Wow. This thing is very, very heavy and solid. Maybe I'll bring it into the set at some point here. Get some flowers. So this isn't just to hold like a nice bouquet of flowers. This thing can hold like a palm tree, and massive flowers and vines. I mean, this is just as sturdy can be. So the next thing is to come across some large container to put a bunch of flowers in, I guess, or something. I don't know what will happen here, but wow, it's pretty exciting, very exciting actually. To the confirmations now are coming in. They're really coming in. Someone even helped me with it. There's all this dust. And he said, let me stop this while you're loading this. Okay, let me help you with this. And all sorts of confirmations that are happening. But I'm at a low tide, low ebb as far as my energy goes. It's just. And sleep doesn't seem to do any much good at all, really. So it's shock, it's shock. And shock takes its own sweet time in wearing off the shock of super positivity. I've been doing some videos of graphics, narrating over them, and that's a lot of fun. But I know everyone likes these live updates. It's very compelling. It certainly is. Because we're in this extraordinary, compelling time right now. We made it. Congratulations to everyone. We just truly we have one more day. Someone told me. Someone's walking through a store. They yell out, I got one more day. One more day. And I'm like, wow. Another confirmation, right? One more day. So, We're getting to it. We're absolutely getting to it here, and we're entering into it. Play is about to begin. So relax, 360-degree confidence. Confidence is where it's about. Super positivity is this great confidence in the teachers, great Dharma kings, the Dharma kings who, they have the skill set. They have the toolbox for us. No question about it. We need not be worried or concerned about that at all. Just have faith in them. They know the right practices. At the right time, the right practices, this, and this. And these practices move us into super positivity. They absolutely do. So you might be feeling something, you know, just if you don't feel really up to stuff, don't panic. Don't think, oh, I didn't make it. No, it's probably because you did make it. And that's a big shock. That's a very big shock. Wow. Just consider that. You're going to super positivity. Super positivity is just tremendous. It's absolutely tremendous. Today I was considering, you know, that there's absolutely no value in this world whatsoever. There's nothing good at all about this world. And instead of being depressed, I was elated. I said, this is great. That means I don't have to ever search here again because I realize there's nothing to find here. There's no super positivity to find in this world. There's no value to find here at all. So in seeing this, the search is over here. You say, the search is over. Nothing to action. Ultimately, you realize then there's nothing to search for. The idea that there's something to search for is the height of arrogance or the depths of it, whichever way you want to put it. How could we, that which, whatever we desire to experience instantly is present and it is experienced by us. We're always in experiencing, 360 degree experiencing. How could we possibly say that there's something we need to search for? Search for? That implies that it's not here right now. That's totally arrogant, totally insane, searching for something. That's ludicrous. So it's great to see, to see that is and the precursor was to see there's nothing positive at all in this world. Not at all. I was thinking about if I had another life, how could I come into the world in a positive way? I could not come up with any way whatsoever that I would like, that it would be acceptable to me. No way whatsoever. I realize it's all negative here. It's all fear-based. It is all fear-based here. It's the super-negative realm, actually. There's only the super-negative and the super-positive. Positivity, ordinary positivity, is the camouflage for super-negativity. I call it the ugly face of arrogance because it's what's more ugly than camouflaging super-negativity? Really, that's terrible. And so that's why we use this aversion practice on positivity, okay? Because it's really, it's like the sweet little lady in an apron offering you poison cookies, you know. So you have to look at her and see her as incredibly ugly, you know, repulsive. Otherwise, you might be, you know, be gentlemanly and say, well, oh, let me take one cookie. And she's smiling, yes, and that's great. And so you have to see the positivity. Put the, you know, aversion training on positivity, aversion practice. What does that do? Opens the door to super positivity because it slams the door shut on super negativity. The attractive face, which we call now the ugly face, we make it ugly. We say, no, that's actually very ugly. Super interesting situation just happened to me coming on home, driving home from work. We were driving on this two-lane road. There was this big, big truck backing out of a driveway, some wealthy mansion there. And they had blocked the traffic going one direction. I was going the other direction. And the cars are kind of slowing down and saying, should we go past? Because the truck was having problems backing out. And cars were still slipping past, but you could tell that there was a lady out there trying to figure out, what do I do? It was the owner of the house. Or at least lady of the house, owner of the house, same thing. Finally, the cars weren't stopping, the truck was having trouble, and she decided, I'm going to come out and just stop traffic. So she started walking across the road and holding her hand up like this. Well, I saw what's happening, and I had to make a decision real quickly. I was the last vehicle there. Everyone else had slipped through, and there was a big line behind me. And I was right in between. I said, I can go through or I can play the gentleman and say, oh, the lady's coming out with her hand. Stop. Let me stop and she'll be, oh, please, oh, thank you for stopping. You know, I said, but wait a minute. The truck isn't ready to back out. I can certainly go through there. Okay. So I'm in a position where I absolutely going through is acceptable. So should I play the gentleman or should I just be the pragmatist? I was the pragmatist. I went through. Didn't stop for her. And this was very significant because this lady was a queen bee to the max. She had this completely super expensive black ensemble on. You know, satin black. Elegant, super rich, and then with this perfect blonde hair in just sort of a natural way, with, you know, showing, look, I don't even have to worry about my hairstyle. You know, it's perfect anyway. Whatever I do, it's perfect. And this was a power queen bee. And she would put up her hand and said, hey, I'm stopping traffic. And I said, well, that's great, but you're not stopping me. And went right through. It was amazing. And I said, wow, you know what? In my past days, I would have stopped. Definitely would have stopped. I said, oh, don't want to get the queen bee mad at me. You know, okay, let me do what she says. But this time I said, no. I'm going through, and I'm going through to super positivity, because these type of queen bees, they're the ugly face of super negativity, actually. Okay, those are the ones that you got to slam the door on and use this aversion practice. Otherwise, you know, you will buy into their whole trip, and they will loop you and direct you back into super negativity, actually, in their service, which they think is, well, so that's very positive. You know, doing what I say and doing what the queen bee says is great. Yeah, but it's positivity, which is only a camouflage for super negativity, for arrogance, actually. It's only a camouflage for arrogance. Positivity here is a camouflage for arrogance. As Jesus said, there's nothing more arrogant than thinking you're a body in a world. That's the height of arrogance. It's completely insane. It's believing that you can change what you are. So that was very telling. That told the tale right there. See, you see how life gives you these little situations, and so many. Everything is a call to repentance. Everything is grace in your life. You just notice it. There's always these subtle little decisions that you're making, and that was just a real quick thing. I didn't really have time to think about it. It was a split second sort of, you know, thing, and I said, I'm not going to get stuck in the service of the queen bees. No way. I'm going through here, getting out of Dodge here. So, multiple indications here. We're all having these indications now, right, in our lives, in our experiencing. I ordered this shirt. I thought it was black and white. It was green and white. I thought the description was black and white, but it green and white. Well, green means go. Go time, doesn't it? So this just arrived today, meaning it's go time. So I wish there was something I could, you know, drink that make me feel better. Don't drink. When you feel shocked, don't drink caffeine. Drinking some lemonade I made, but keep in mind, shock is, you have to recognize, where did it come from? It's super positive, all right? It's the shock of the super positive. Just abide in it. Get through it without going for the energy drinks and the caffeine and stimulants and all this stuff. And it's tough, yeah. It was very clumsy today. You can feel when you're really clumsy, you're in a state of shock, actually. And it's tough because you'd like to function in a super optimal way, right? But you can't on the path, spiritual path. You have to accept you're going to be suboptimal. You're not going to excel, be optimally functioning, because you're going through the shock process of shocking, super positive shocks, glimpses of reality, glimpses of freedom, shock us. But again, for me, I've had previous lifetimes of super optimal functioning, very high functioning, and so already know what that's like. It's not the answer. So I'm willing to have lived a life of suboptimal functioning here, in order to shift my attention to clear light vision of intrinsic spaciousness. That's the price you pay. That's the cross that Jesus said. You have to carry your cross. Well, obviously, if Jesus is carrying his cross, he's not functioning optimally. I mean, he's not walking on water and doing all this stuff. He's dragging this heavy cross along. And this is what we have to do. We dragging this heavy cross along. We're not going to be functioning so great. Just basic functioning. I mean, I'm not a standout in any way in this world, in those terms at all. People just think I'm just sort of, I mean, very low, actually, very kind of, the kind of person who really is very suboptimal, and that's just, they can't do anything about it, and so they just get the menial, low grade stuff. And it's not easy, but again, having been in the super high functional levels before, I just said that's, it was just absolutely not the answer. So it's worth it to go through the humility, some humiliation, but not so bad if you just accept it and realize what the benefits of it. It doesn't really get to you too much. It's really never gotten to me too badly, actually, because I carry the confidence through. So yeah, if I look like a bum, low, well, let me just keep treating people with grace and love and grace, and people still smile at me and treat me well, and you'd be surprised how nicely other people around the bottom treat you, because they say, what, hey, I know it's not easy being down here. And you smile, you're nice to them, they're nice to you. Everybody's been nice to me, really, on the bottom. They're just pretty interesting education. It's not easy, but these people, they don't complain. They don't complain. Wow. I see people in all sorts of very low type of jobs, the lowest of the low, and they're not complaining. They still smile. I mean, a guy today obviously has had a real tough life living, working on a real bottom of the barrel job, and I chatted him up. We had a nice talk, and we're both very positive. I wished him just have a great day, and he's, oh, thank you, buddy. He was very nice and positive to me. This is how it is. You treat everybody, because keep in mind, everyone's already been saved. So you're talking about, you're talking to, you're always talking with someone who's just as saved as you are. We're all perfectly saved. Only took an instant. Time only lasts an instant, and the Holy Spirit saved us all in an instant. When I say save, I mean saved us from delay. I mean, ultimately, delay has all been collapsed. Time has all been collapsed. We're just honoring the memory of time, actually. We're just honoring the memory of time, memory of our creativity, with all this foolishness, this super negativity. And some want to keep on another cycle of honoring that. That's fine if they want to do that. And others realize that they've done plenty to honor it, and it's time now to recognize that time, never was really. And then time, space, process, and form is just a silly wish, idle wish, and that we've just been wandering around aimlessly. That's it. But it's a great advantage. Blessed are the meek in spirit, for they shall inherit the kingdom. This is very true. Having this job on the bottom of the barrel, not much is expected of me as far as optimal functioning. Therefore, I can take the spiritual path. You see how that is? It's similar to the 84 Mahasiddhas, the tradition in India, in northern India, in Buddhism, that area, Tibetan Buddhism, 84 Mahasiddhas. This is the tradition of those who come from these sort of lowly positions in society, who characters are kind of ragged, who are not optimal functioning. They're kind of odd, a little bit don't fit in quite to society and such. And those are the ones that reached enlightenment. There's this tradition that you know, saying, you can do it wherever you're at. The cobbler, the garbage man, the undertaker, just the lazy bum, the wanderer. They have all these funny names for these Mahasiddhas who, if you looked at them in the world, you think, ah, oh, they don't not gonna amount to anything, not gonna amount to anything. But keep in mind when you, the world views you as just a basic suboptimal, the Sudra class or something like that, just do the real dirty menial jobs, which is really pretty much what I do. I've been a Sudra this life. I really have. Whatever job is, dirtiest and yuckiest and stuff, that's what people give me. I say, oh, here, can you do, this is your job, you do this. I say, ah, oh, okay. Yeah, it's kind of cheerfully okay. Your clothes are gonna get filthy, dust everywhere, just nasty, nasty stuff. And so people just assume I'm not gonna amount to anything. But again, without that pressure of having to amount to a lot, you can go through the wow of all these deep, deep experiences, the shock, shock, shock of super positivity, and you can still schlep along in your job and function okay. And if you mess up, people say, ah, well, what do you expect? I messed up. No big deal, no big deal. clean up the gutters, sweep the gutters, clean up the gutters. So actually, it's an advantage. It's an advantage. It's a great advantage. Being poor and being lowly in society is a huge advantage. Being poor is you can't afford diversions. Not really. Of course, we got TV these days, and the internet, which are both really nasty, and most people can't afford those, unfortunately. Whereas in the past, if you didn't have money, you couldn't really afford any diversions at all. Now you can always turn on the television set and watch something, get a beer, and watch a football game. So that's why the Holy Spirit just told me it's really important not to watch television. Don't listen to the radio, watch television. These are all kind of pretty much free, not entirely free, but pretty much free diversions. Read books, etc. In the past, no. But the real nice diversions, you can't afford it. A lot of things, not being able to afford it is an extreme advantage, because you say, well, what can I do? I can either, watch a football game, or I can do some spiritual practice. And if you're boycotting culture, which I am really, spiritual practice is the only way to go. So, huge advantage. Again, if I had money, I wouldn't have made it. I wouldn't have made it. If I had a high position, responsible position in the world, I wouldn't have made it. So the combination of a very lowly position and very, very poor. So poor you can't afford diversions. I can't say, hey, I'm going to go to Disneyland this Memorial Day weekend. I can't say that. I can't do that. Or I can't say I'm going anywhere. So I don't even plan. I don't even think, 3 day weekend, where are you going to go? Where am I going to go? What are you talking about? I'm going to, just be, hammering away at the videos and taping and full on focus on the spiritual path. Like I always do. Now, if something comes up, God wants something to happen, then it'll happen. Something might help you do something or something like that. I say, okay, but as far as planning or thinking about it, there's nothing like that going on with me. I just, full focus on spiritual, on the super positivity. So I was given hugely advantageous. I chose a hugely advantageous position. It's interesting that the Nyingma tradition, which is the ancient tradition of Tibetan Buddhism, started with by Padmasambhava. All homage to Padmasambhava, the lotus-born one. they have this very strong tradition of just lay household or lay people who are not really, or hooked up with a guru or lama or whatever, them studying and being very successful, very successful. Part of their strength. It might just be a shepherd, an old a shepherd or whatever, someone who puts, horseshoes on something or whatever, blacksmith or whatever, just tradesman, blue collar, whatever, low position, and yet, but just normal, humble people, and yet they're actually practicing, practicing, practicing. They end up becoming enlightened. They end the search. They realize we don't need to search for what is always present, which is our immediate spontaneous experiencing. How could we be searching for experiencing? We're already experiencing. So maybe Longchenpa is like, hey, you fit right in. I mean, it feels very comfortable because I'm not part of some, formal tradition at all. I've just been like in a cave for my whole life, basically, just without any, just talking about it, just practicing. And then gradually I started talking about it on the videos here, just because eventually you have to get up to speed and start sharing your be helpful. You have to be helpful. Or you get to be helpful. Most traditions, they say, well, what you just study under? Where's your resume? Whereas in Yingma, the great completion, the ancient, what was it? The ancient teacher or something, and Dzogchen, the great completion. They're very comfortable with just these mavericks who work outside of any formal tradition. That's actually part of their tradition. So super positive is where we are headed, what we're practicing now, and we need to now benefit to super positivity is you have to practice it. Okay, that's the great benefit, right? So we'll be more directly practicing it, just as the super negatives will be more directly practicing super negativity. And they feel they've got this world. The benefit for them of this world is that they're going to be able to practice super negativity here. That's why they're here. Because this world is set up now for super negativity. However, we have a way to practice super positivity. There may be a place set up for us to practice super positivity. Very, very well may be. It's interesting, this shirt got here fast. It was expensive. Like, there's no other option. They only gave me one option, priority mail. But it did arrive in a big hurry, actually. No kidding. 2 days. It was very fast. So, yeah, very, very tremendous. It's great to have these deadlines. It forces you really into to just working as fast as possible to prepare, 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 prepare. Very helpful. So when you really feel tired, just keep laughing, keep smiling. Maybe you're too tired to laugh. I pretty much am. And don't panic, don't freak out. You'll bounce back from it. This cloud of shock does wear off. It does wear off as you start to get used to it. And again, the insights you have, be very careful, don't struggle with them. I've had two insights now, they're absolutely crucial. I realize how crucial they are, but I say, okay, they're com it's coming. It's coming. Maybe the third time's a charm. I'm not going to try to remember what the first one was when I had the second one. Try to string them together. You know, it's just emerging beneath the surface now. And at some point, it will just emerge. And as the tide goes down, the island emerges, so to speak. And you see it. You say, ah, okay. So I know it's there. I know it's very crucial. Really flipping the script. Always prayed it to have the, for the Dharma Kings to flip the script for you. Grace of God, flip the script. We're not trying to struggle along horizontally within the premise and the momentum of this premise. We're trying to change the premise, flip the whole script. Just all at once, flip the script all at once. This is the key to success. Always look to flip the script, not to figure anything out. Not to be figuring or struggling along with what came before. Okay, all this stuff came before, now I have to. No, just flip the entire script upside down. Because this whole world's upside down and backwards. Everything here is upside down and backwards. So you can't solve it within that context at all. Flip the whole script right side up, the right way. Forwards, right side up, all of that good stuff. So this is what we prepare for, is super positivity, which means flipping the script. Positivity is just trying to keep working your way and find a prettier lump of coal. That's what positivity is, finding a prettier lump of coal. So we're spending all our time sorting through this coal bin. Most people don't have coal anymore. I don't have coal. I don't think I've ever had a piece of coal in my hand. But let's just say a rock bin, all these rocks. And you're just sorting through these rocks and pebbles and stones and trying to find, oh, that looks like I might be a nice one here. And that's positivity. Go over to the bin that has got nothing but these golden diamonds of all different beautiful types. Every one is just sublime. And start looking at those. Say, oh, I like this one. Oh, this, I like this one. Oh, this is wonderful. And we don't have to say, well, I got to find one that's prettier because the others are ugly. We say, no, they're all good. I'm just going to enjoy each one. Wow, here's, let me find, look, another one. Oh, this is beautiful. Let me put it back. And this one is great. This, oh, I love it. This, they're all wonderful. So it's a different thing. Super positivity. It's all good. It's all wonderful. Now, when you feel like this tired, it's tough because for me, I've been working out. I've been doing everything I can healthy in every which way to try and feel great at this time. And here I am just as flat as a pancake. So you might think it's very demoralizing, but I it's worth it because I got this great shock. I was able to break this band of control of super negativity. The deepest, cleverest way is trying to keep a hold of me. So, you know, you make some supreme effort and you get the result, and then there's this temporary backlash. But once it wears off, you know, I'll be flying high. That is for sure. Absolutely. This pigeon flew in right over my head inside the store, inside Home Depot. I was just getting ready to leave, walking out. Suddenly this bird just came whoosh, right over my head and just whoosh, and perched there. I was like, wow, very cool. Here comes the grace of God into the open area, big area, walking, exiting Home Depot. There's this pretty big area exit. And where the construction area is, all those desks, where, you know, it's just wide open because a lot of big heavy stuff go out there. So it's kind of an open to the air, right? Open to the sky, open to the air, and it's kind of an open area. So this is where we want to be. We want to be in this super positive area where it's easy for us to walk out. And we are. We're there. At least those who've been working on familiarity. Familiarity is the key. All these little shocks of getting familiar, they all add up. They all add up. The whole purpose is to avoid the super negativity for sure. And again, the positive is the worst part of super negativity. And this is where the politicians are, why they're so dangerous. They're the experts at being positive. We don't want positivity, we want super positivity. Again, positivity is the trap. And of course we don't want negativity, but positivity is negativity, actually. It's just this little trick game we play to camouflage it. But it's super negative, absolutely. Are you kidding? It says, oh yeah, you're a body, you know, you're born and then you age and you die, you know, and you're buried in the ground and that's it. And this is your home and this is your one chance to be happy. And yeah, you're going to get sick, but we got surgeons and medicines and, you know, and on and on and on and on. All this positivity. Look how great the world is. We could plant some flowers, plant a tree, blah, blah, blah. This is just asserting the arrogant position that we're not spirit. Exactly as God created us to be, right? But it's asserting it in what they call a positive way. But how could asserting a negative be positive? It's not. It's still negative. It's still arrogance. It's still a lie. It's still self-deception. So stating a lie in a charming manner is very bad, isn't it? It's better to be a lie to be presented in a negative manner, so it's easier to see. Negative people are not so frightening because, you know, they'll admit, yeah, I'm negative, yeah, I feel terrible, yeah, I probably don't listen to me, I'm just negative. But the charming people, those are the ones that are dangerous in terms of charming positivity, because they're the marketers, they're the sellers on that. Now, of course, when we're presenting super positivity, we want to present it in a attractive way, of course. That's fine. Nothing wrong with presenting truth in an attractive way. But there's everything wrong with presenting lies in an attractive way, right? That's what we have to avoid. Which is aversion practice comes in very, very, very handy for that, actually. Entirely warranted now. Because we've reached this event threshold time now. And you will begin to experience this parting of the ways between the super negative and the super positive. And there's really nothing in between. There never has been. There never has been. Again, the positive is actually just a camouflage for the super negative. So all this belief that there's some third place, you know, it's neither super positive nor super negative, doesn't exist. Never has existed. Never has existed. We've all always either been in super negative or super positive. Always. So the lie is to recognize the positive and see that it's really super negativity in disguise. It always has been. This is a bit of a shock seeing this. But this is what I tried to message, I tried to bring to the world. And to say the least, the positives of the world didn't like it. Right? Of course not. That's the last thing they want to hear. Just like Jesus said, gave in to the righteous, the self-righteous, he just absolutely told them off, saying, no, these are the ones that are the last to get to the kingdom of heaven. These are the farthest away, the self-righteous. This is true. This is true. And of course, they don't like to hear that at all. They're doing everything they can do to sell you on super negativity by camouflaging it. That's terrible. It's like someone who has a used car that doesn't run, and it's a lemon, and they know it. And they do everything they can do to dress it up and make it look so great and be an attractive salesperson for it and sell that car. And then someone drives off the lot and it falls apart. You know, that's very bad. That's terrible, isn't it? It's better if you say, look, I got this terrible car. You know, it's going to fall apart. It's no good. It's a piece of junk. But I want you to buy it anyway. And then you might say, ah, you know, thanks for being honest, and I don't really want it, so I'm not going to buy it, but I appreciate your honesty about it. So that's why Jesus said, some of these people that you see in the world, they're going to reach heaven way before the righteous Pharisees and Sadducees will reach heaven, kingdom of heaven, way before. This was his radical message. And the righteous ones, they got quite upset. So I've experienced this, that in trying to deliver this message. It's just a message of truth, is what it is. Jesus brought truth into this world, and those who follow Jesus' example are called upon to bring truth into this world. And I found that it gets a very frosty reception, say the least, among the self-righteous positive ones. They just, you know, they don't, it, because this, you know, basically spills the beans on their camouflage act. And for them, they feel that you know, that arrogance is salvation, so they want to sell themselves on it. So if they sell you, that they think they sell themselves, you see? This is what the marketers do. If they, what they're really trying to do is sell themselves on something. So if they can get you to buy into it, they say, oh, well, they like it, and they're real smart, and they went for it, so maybe it is good. You know, they got some, of course, doubts in their minds, and so the more people they sell on it, the more they're trying to erase those doubts. But what good does it do to erase doubts about following a lie? It's still a lie, isn't it? It's still a lie. No matter how many self-doubts we think we've erased, doesn't matter. It's still a lie. And we still won't be happy. So it really is a waste of time to try and, you know, put a positive spin on lies. So it's important to keep going over the basics, because those are the things that we most need to utilize, and we're prone to forget this stuff in the stress of this world, as the positives try to drag us down. And I find, instead of struggling mentally with the positives, just use aversion practice. Just make the positives appear as this horrible virus-laced pus that is, I don't know how many viruses they've had recently, but you go back through history, it's just full of smallpox and cholera and typhoid and Junta virus and the Zika, and how many viruses, the AIDS virus and every hideous virus possible. It's absolutely, you know, just full of this, and you're being asked to drink this, you know, you just have to absolutely shock, you know, just throw the cup down, you know, recoil from it, jump back from it. Just like I jumped out of the way of that car that was going to run me down. At some point, you just got to jump out of the way, right? Because I was walking across, and this lady in the parking lot, she wasn't going to stop. And at some point, you know, you, if you're really stupid, you'll just say, well, she's supposed to stop, therefore I'm just going to keep walking, and to heck with her, you know. This will get you killed. Okay, that will get you killed. Now, there are a lot of people that have done that. So I'm just following my rules, and so she's supposed to follow her rules, and so I'm not going to, you know, move for her, and she's going to have to stop. Well, guess what? She just claimed she didn't see you. Oops, ran you over, killed you. I never saw you. So I said, hey, you know, for me, I said, it was great. That was another test. I'm not going to, it was a test, because I was thinking, like, well, I need to be the gentleman. If I jump out of the way, then she's going to know that she almost hit me. But if I just keep walking, you know, play the gentleman, I don't want to upset her and make her think that she almost hit me. You see how that works? This whole thing of being a gentleman is really a way to put you in the grave. It's really a way to put people in the grave. It might, maybe being a lady might be the same thing, right? It can be a trap. So, and of course, she was very upset that, because, oh, I didn't see her, the side. She was very flustered that she almost hit me. Because I made it apparent, you know, ran and I kind of turned around, you know. It's very interesting. I think she may have expected me just to play the gentleman and get run over. And then she would have cried hysterical. I couldn't see the sun. It was an accident, blah, blah, blah. And nothing would have happened to her, of course. Of course. So that was another test, really interesting. It's amazing how we think everyone's going to follow the rules. And if I follow the rules, therefore you should too. And this whole thing, and then not wanting to upset anybody by insinuating that they may not be functioning optimally or something. But you see, we're used to not functioning optimally. So for me, it's okay. So, well, she's not functioning optimally. That's okay. Maybe she just had a big wow, spiritual wow. And that's why. So we do need to look out for one another. Okay? We're our brother's keeper, so to speak. We do need to look out. And so I was just looking out for her. I said, here's someone. Maybe she's not functioning optimally. There doesn't seem like she is. Okay, let me. And I said, okay, let me get out of the way so she doesn't make things even worse for her. So maybe she's had a tremendous. Maybe she's having a day like I've had today, where she had a great spiritual breakthrough, and now she's feeling the shock of it, and it's just, just out of it. It's understandable. It happens. I was really out of it today, and I could hardly see. It seems like my attention, awareness was so tired. I so low in some way. I was like driving, like, am I seeing or am I not seeing? My eyes are open. How well was I really seeing? That's a question. So she may have been something like that. So by all means, get out of the way when someone's acting in a suboptimal way. Help them out that way, like I did. I dashed out of the way. I helped her out. Unfortunately, that day I was able to dash. 2 days ago, I had lots of energy. And today, I don't think I'm not in a dashing mood at all. It's just like, let's not dash at all. So really, our experiencing is quite extraordinary. These little events are very telling events. And when you're this low, don't try to think about the future. What are you going to do now? I mean, just like, because you become demoralized because you don't have any energy. So just accept the low times. Take the good with the bad with the good. And just rest. You may need to rest. Remember, we're into super positivity. We're not into positivity. We don't have to be doing do-gooders running around filling the world with flowers. That's not super positivity. That's camouflage for super negativity, which is the belief we can change what we are. We can change what God is, what reality is. That's super negativity. Sometimes we feel this way, you call it really burned out, really burned out. But it's slightly different than a burnout. It's a shock reaction, aftershock. It's like the tsunami is hitting. It's not surprising. But the good thing is it doesn't hit all immediately. So this is a couple days delayed. So this is something to be aware of, that when you have these great breakthroughs, you may feel fine for several days. Absolutely, it's not a problem. And then gradually, you start feeling some of the after effects of the shock, like, wow, that was really very intense. But by that time, you've already gotten used to it to a certain extent. And so you're able to smooth it out and get through it. So don't be afraid to do these practices and have the success. It's not going to be so bothersome. And down the road, you feel some effects, but I say, well, that's not too much. That's not too much of a price to pay, not at all. It's still very cool here. I think it's supposed to be warming up. Just in the mid-80s type of thing, 80-ish. Supposed to be some clear, very nice weather here. It's been very odd weather here recently, but it's going to be clear in, mid-80s going towards July, June here. And June is when now, I mean, from May 27th, 26/27th, going forward, we have this, the long hot summer of 216, the events where super positivity and super negativity will make their entrance upon the stage. There's no question about it. I really believe that this is what will happen. And we could just take it in stride because we've trained for super positivity. And the benefit of that is we get to train some more. That we don't have to go along with the positivity / super negativity agenda of really training for super negativity. We don't have to do that. We have the opportunity now to really focus in on super positivity with some great teachers who are you know, the best at it. So this is like really, really great news for us. So it's the best of times and it's the worst of times right now. We're entering into that phase, the best of times and worst of times. Our experience here in this world is kind of cool, actually. If you're kind of aware of the bigger picture, it's really quite astonishing, this world and our play we're putting on here. Very intense situation as far as it's like a high stakes game, high stakes poker game. I mean, you know, you don't want to go into super negativity. No, 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 you don't. And we're full of drama. History has, and it's no exception right now. It's if you want drama, we're going to have it now. Both super negative and super positive. Super positive drama is coming too. And this is more difficult because we're not used to it. We're used to the super negative that we've been dwelling in it for so long. So the super positive is really a challenge for us. It's quite difficult to accept it. Yeah, wow, really? Like that bin in the dream, bin of golden diamonds. I just, oh my gosh, this is just so super positive. I'm not used to this. But I said, yeah, I can get used to this. People trying to blame my fatigue on a diet. Too much sugar, too much this, too much this. It must be something. No, it's nothing in the diet. It's the shock of a major breakthrough, a very unexpected snapping of that huge steel band that positivity had fashioned to try and control me and take all my energy, take all my will, and turn it towards, you know, serving arrogance. That band was snapped, much to the chagrin and outrage of the ones who were hoping to utilize me in that way. They were hoping to get a big boost for themselves in that way. So they're you know, quite consternated that that's not going to happen for them. But that's okay. That's all part of the drama, too. It's part of their drama, also. I had to sleep yesterday, too. I slept like till from 4 to 6 or something, or 3 to 7. I mean, I slept a lot. I had to. It's really rough right now. This transitional period in history. It's fair to say that this is the most crucial transitional period in history. It's absolutely fair to say that. That's why we put so much effort into this one. This is the big one. There have been many transitional times in history, but this is the big one. Because the road to super negativity is well paved and greased and lined with flowers, and off you go. You know, and so it's very, very crucial now to go to the road of super positivity, also lined with flowers, and with great teachers and great confidence. Beautiful stones are paved. You know, golden diamonds are the paving stones, whereas the others are just paved with lumps of coal or, you know, and everybody's saying, "Wow, look at this piece of coal. This looks a little better than that other one over there. I mean, I can't, it's unbelievable, huh? How great this coal is. It's got we got attributes here." It's like wine, you know. People are just like so into wine in this area of the world. It's like pieces of coal, and they're so. You know, just it blows their mind that they're able to find differences that are, you know, meaningful differences to them. Oh yeah, I could really taste the kind of earthen cherry, turmeric, you know, iron in this, you know, the wine is just, cause it's, you know, I could, yeah, oh, this is really profound. Yeah. I never got into that at all, you know, because it's you're looking at lumps of coal and trying to find differences. Bottom line, it's a lump of coal. It's not a diamond. It's not a golden diamond. What are you doing digging in the coal bin when you got this bin right here full of golden diamonds? It's arrogant to say that that's going, coal's going to satisfy you, lumps of coal. And I say by you, I mean everyone, the plural you, of course. But it is rather frightening when you get knocked out like this. The delayed reaction of stress and shock. Wow. It's no fun. It's no fun because you wonder, am I ever, I'm going to recover from this? You know? Yeah. I mean, a big old heavy rain cloud goes overhead and it seems like the sun's blotted out forever, but it, you know, it moves on and the sun comes back out. So. In the meantime, you feel like, well, you know, pretty suboptimal. There's not much I can do. I keep thinking, oh, I should do this and this and this and this. I say, yeah, if I felt good, I would do it. But I feel so terrible. Let me just rest. The super negatives are using dogs as oracles, really. That's what it's all about. For them, it's dog. Dog is a guide to the underworld of super negativity. Instead of God, they use dog. Opposite of God. Very prevalent. Extremely prevalent. It's amazing. Dogs in churches, dogs in doctor's offices. Next thing you know, you'll see dogs in hospitals, restaurants. Stores of all types, just theaters. You know, it's a dog's life. They'll come up with more and more excuses. Well, I'm emotionally challenged. So I need to have this dog. You know, it's a companion dog. Oh, okay. So bring it into the restaurant. And this, you know, the positives think, oh, it's so positive. It's so positive. What it means is it's so helpful in helping us move away from the super positive. This little bird there chirping away. I love birds because they can fly away. They're free, you know, to just. There's no rules for birds, is there? No, it just. They can just fly in like this, like that, and then take off for parts unknown. So spontaneous, you know. Where does a bird go? It goes wherever it wants to go. Directly, right? Fly to the top of a tree, can come down to the ground, it can go anywhere. Very cool life, the life of birds. Yeah, maybe if we take an incarnation, it can be as a bird. It's They just go wherever they want to go. Amazing. But they always have to be alert and looking for food and all this kind of stuff. So it's not that much fun. Maybe the Garuda bird, as the Vajrayana Buddhism says, the great Garuda bird hatches. It's fully functional as it hatches from the egg. It's completely functional. They say enlightenment's like that. When we come out of the egg, the clear light vision of intrinsic spaciousness, we're fully functional in that. We're not like a little fledgling. It might fall out of the nest and can't fly. You know, no, we're not fledgling. We come out zooming. So I'll try to do the best I can. Right now it's suboptimal, sure. But you know, somehow keeping on when you're in the suboptimal state because of the great shock of breakthrough, that itself is actually very, very good. Because it's right practice, right showcasing that this is how it is. Tremendous breakthroughs are shocking, snapping these steel bands that were thought to be unsnappable. Yeah, that's quite stunning. And it really stunned the ones that were using that hold on me, hoping they had a hold on me. They would have a hold on me. Boy, were they sent for a turn. I'll tell you what. Surprised the heck out of them. They don't realize in their arrogance, they believe that whatever they say is true. Therefore, when they say that there's nothing that can snap the band, they believe it's truth. And nothing, therefore, can snap the band. So when the band is snapped, it casts into doubt all their truth, right? It casts doubt upon arrogance. So this is what this consternation that they're bellowing. Wow, they're just bellowing in great consternation. Because arrogance, their arrogance says, you know, you can't snap this. Nothing can snap this. Well, it just snapped. So they can't count on arrogance. Like, wow, arrogance doesn't give the right advice. Quite shocking. Now, you might feel like you're coming down with a cold or the flu or something terrible. Don't let that get into you. No, it's the after effect of this breakthrough. Very sour. Wow. And so don't panic, because if you start panicking, it can turn into a cold or a flu. It really can. But if you just take it as the wow, full stop on the wow, and say the cold, not now cold, maybe later, I'll might turn a wow into a cold, but not right now. This is just shock of the wow. Then it pushes away that fear. It pushes it away. Cold and flus are just a form of fear. So full stop in the wow really is a great, great medical treatment. Super great medical treatment. It's way better than just breathing right. You know, the yoga girls teach how to breathe right, etc. But that's just a positive context of putting that in. Where full stop in the wow is put into a super positive context. So it's way, way better. All this new age stuff about yoga and all this kind of stuff, that's just positivity. It's not super positivity. You know, studies have shown that, you know, our sympathetic nervous system calms down if we breathe more slowly. And studies have shown, so they're studying the nervous system and the brain. Studies have shown. This is all positivity. And we think we're okay. Say, oh, I know how to break and breathe, you know. Oh, I calm my myself down. So that's great. I'm very positive, very positive. Well, this distracts us from the real work. Gives a false sense of, gives over sense of overconfidence and smartness, or smart. But we're not doing the super positivity work at all. We're avoiding it. We're avoiding it through the use of positivity. So we use positivity to avoid super positivity. We say, no, I'm doing positivity. Well, we're not called to positivity. We're called to super positivity, or mega super positivity, as I like to say. And we pull out our, here we go, tell them what they've won. We've won super mega. We pull out our super mega. Super mega positivity here. Super mega positivity. Super mega positivity. Right? This is what we need. This is what we need. Super mega positivity. Super mega positivity. Super mega positivity. Super mega positivity. Yeah. Okay. A little rah-rah thing. So, yeah. The difference between super positivity and super negativity, well, it's different direction, of course. And the super negatives, believing in arrogance, will say, well, it has to be similar because truth is whatever we say, claim it to be. And so it's impossible to get through to them in this way. To tell them, well, no, is explain the difference, because they say, well, for us, we're just going to claim it's the same, so it is the same. That's arrogance. Arrogance just makes us up its own rules as it goes along in terms of, you know, what is true and what is not true. So if arrogance wants to say, well, it's the same, then it believes it's the same. So it doesn't understand what you're talking about. It thinks it's already decreed it's the same, and so what do you? You're just an idiot not understanding truth if you say it's different directions. This is the trouble with arrogance, is it not? It's pretty much, you know, unreachable. You have to repent. You have to repent and realize that arrogance, what it's up to. You know, you have to acknowledge, wow, arrogance is just making up its own rules to suit its purposes as it goes along. And this is terrible. This will never work. You have to realize that. Otherwise, you're going to, you know, keep being fooled by arrogance for sure. So that you can't explain differences to arrogance. It just overrules them. Says, oh, that's a difference? Okay, I just say it's not a difference anymore. Boom, solved. Case closed. That's what it does. It sees the same, what it seems the different as the same, and the same is different. That's arrogance's way. That's what Jesus says. How we do it here? Oh, good. I'm tired. Super, super tired. Super mega tired. But I just try to keep working and have gratitude for what's already been done. The Dharma Kings have greatness in store for us, super positivity in store for us. So we need to have gratitude towards that. Claim it, empower it, approve all approvals, all empowerments, all permissions, approvals, empowerments. For anything and everything that has to do with super positivity, all empowerments and permissions and approvals for anything and everything, and all gratitude because we know it's already done for us. See, that's the heart of the super positivity. It's already done for us. It's already done. We're already been saved from arrogance. Already. It's already happened. Whereas the super negatives say, no. We It'll only happen when you know when we decide and we just it just it's never it's not yet, not yet, not yet. It's always not yet. But we say no, it is right now. It's already happened. It's already happened. Super mega positivity SMS. That's the real SMS, isn't it? Super mega. No, SMP. 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 Super positive. Super mega positivity. SMP. Now, I just thought about like hanging out with this, with a great with a, hanging out with the Dharma King, and the idea was like really. I said I can do it. That's how I felt. First time I really felt that way. So it means we're far along here. You just do it. You don't expect too much right off the bat, but. You just say, okay, this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to hang out with them. That's it. And I have faith that this will bear fruit. I have great faith this will bear the fruit that I'm looking for. What else do you need to hang out with the Dharma Kings, except for great faith that this is going to bear the fruit that we really want? I don't know any other qualification that, really, right? That's it. They're just abiding in the clear light vision of intrinsic spaciousness is all. And it's just a simple shift of our attention for us to abide in that as well. So we just hang out within this ambience of 360-degree ambience of empowerments and permissions and acceptances and familiarities and just go from there with faith that this is what works. They might suggest at some point a little practice of one sort or another. So this will help speed it up if you want to. You'll get there anyway, but this might speed it up a little bit. It's like that. I get there, meaning you're already there. You're already 360 degree experiencing. There's nowhere else to be. Big areas of my life when I was younger suddenly like emerging like from forgetfulness. Suddenly I remember this whole constellation of earlier in my life and did this and this and this, all this stuff's just emerging. I just say, wow, that's great. I thought I had lost it forever, forgotten it. No, it's still there, it's still viable. I just like, oh yeah, I remember that. And it was experiencing then too, wasn't it? And this is experiencing too right now. We're always experiencing. We're always in 360-degree experiencing. There's no other place to be. Arrogance always acts in a way to distance yourself from truth, and Holy Spirit always acts in a way to get you closer, to attract you to it. That is true. Okay, so I don't want to push things here. I'm pretty doggone tired. Maybe I'll make some more, you know, graphics videos with, you know, artistic graphic stuff that, from time to time, you may want to just chill out and watch that, and just for the heck of it, you know, like if you want to watch a song, listen to a song on YouTube. What I listened to something last night, one way or the other. Yeah, that's the song I heard in the doctor's office, in the nurse's station there. It like really was a huge like boost for me. Oh wow, they really mean business. They're the Dharma Kings are really here, and because they know this is the decisive act of the play is coming right now. In terms of delay or non-delay. So very exciting time. Our play of super positivity is about to commence in a very, very, very tremendous, super positive way. How else would it be? Super positive will present in a super positive way. Of course, it has to. That's what it's all about. It, to present in any other way, what is that? It's positivity. You know, it's got to be present in a super positive way. So I do my best to present in a super positive way. It's not always easy because we're so used to thinking that positivity is the answer. No, it's not the answer. Super positivity is the answer. So again, we're so used to examining these lumps of coal or these stones and trying to come up with these significant differences, like bottles of wine. Oh, this was so much better than this one. This one seems flat. This one's got so full-bodied, you know, robust. And so there's all these subtleties. The palate is so amazing. This one's not so good. We tried drawing all these differentiations between these stones. But over in this, the right bin on the right side is this just golden diamonds. If you can even imagine what that's like. It's hard to imagine it. That dream, I experienced it. It's diamonds, just like combination of gold and diamonds. Wow, giving off this just beautiful light, and they're so beautiful. Just that super positivity, and trying to find difference between lumps of coal is positivity. So how can we say it's the same? The sameness is superficial, and it's really what sameness. We're not sorting through the diamond, the golden diamonds. They're all beautiful. We don't need to sort through them. We just do whatever, just spontaneously, this one, spontaneous. We're not trying to learn anything. We're not trying to learn the differences. So it's really, there's really no real true similarities at all, actually. And when people say, well, I don't have the right to that, you know, what, I don't have the familiarity to do it? Again, this dream, it was pointed out to me, no, you can do it, sure, why not? It's okay, you got the right to do it. I was wondering, do I have the right to do this? Can I do it? Yeah. It's okay. So, I'd love to drop some more beautiful videos on everyone. I mean, I try to put the best music I can find. It's different. I try to give a 360-degree experiencing, okay? It's not just going to be one particular thing. I don't want us to get fixated on some fixation. Is 360 degree. The one with I haven't put it up yet. Maybe I need to make an intro to that. Maybe I'll do that. Yeah, let me do that. Okay. I will make an intro video to one of these videos I have ready to go, because I need to explain it to you. Otherwise I'll get a little kind of big. What is this? Okay, very great. I will do that right now. So hang in there, everybody. We're doing super great. Absolutely doing super great. And don't be concerned about the rewards. I'm already playing in the gold diamond bin. Okay, so throwing those around. Everybody, here's a gold diamond. Here, have a golden diamond. Have another one. Here, have more. And so It's all great. It's all super positive here. Okay, and get your rest and don't power through with caffeine or stimulants or whatever. Don't try to power through it. Just accept your suboptimalness. If you're working at schlepping away at some lowly job and you say, "What am I doing?" You know, hey, just realize, hey, whatever lowly job you have, I probably have a lower one. Okay. And however low your status is, my status is probably lower. It's pretty difficult to get a lower status than I have. And as far as my life goes, it's pretty difficult to have any less success than I've had. So don't worry about it. I can succeed having such a lowly life. You can certainly succeed as well. So take it as an advantage. See the advantage in it. You might be just some poor schmuck in this store, clerk or something. Or just some guy told me he's getting a new job, and I say, "What's the job?" "Well, underground construction." "What do you mean?" "Well, yeah, we're digging up water. We're digging up water mains." "So, yeah, oh." And he says, "Yeah, I'm probably going to be the guy holding the sign that says stop or slow, stop or slow." I see those all the time now. And I always kind of wave at him, and give him a thumbs up, like, "Hey, thanks. I know your job is lowly, but why don't you practice your spiritual breakthroughs and use this job in order to make breakthroughs?" And this guy could do some way better than that. He's very sharp, man. This guy is somebody you would want to hire in your company because he's really good, and yet he's just gonna be holding a sign saying stop and slow. I mean, so, but yeah, he said, "Well, the better the job I got," you say that. But not really, no, I don't know, it's pretty lowly too, right? But so if you have a lowly job, it's great, super great, right? You might be a very fortunate one. If your finances are low too, you say, "Ah, wow, how fortunate I am. This is super great. So I'm really now going to be able to get into the super positive more and more and more and more and more." Okay, very great. That's it. Full stop in the wow. Always remember that. Locate the wow, the shock of breakthrough, and be patient and kind and compassionate with yourself, and you will bounce back from it, as I always have. That's it.